everybody, welcome to Dark Ethics Cooking Show. Today we are making honey yucky, which is very delicious. I created this recipe myself and had a lot of fun making it. It's one of my favorite things to make at home completely so far because it make it into meat skewers. So I use beef, but you can use chicken. If you use chicken, gotta make it sure it's all the way cooked to at least 175 degrees on the inside or is white all the way through. Steak, you can cook it like any other steak, like rare, medium rare, well done, which is this atrocity. And you can use goat or anything like that, but beef or chicken would work really well, or you can even use tofu. But you gotta make sure it's firm so that way it doesn't slide off or break off, because, yeah, nobody wants that. It's gonna hurt. That'd be a bugger. But then, you throw stir fry a veg into it and make it into a stir fry. Anyway, I hope you do enjoy this episode. Hi everybody, today we're gonna be making honey yucky beef skewers. So this is gonna be fun. So what you're gonna do is a pound of cubed beef. So this beef is gonna be about roughly that size. And you go put it in the Ziploc baggie. You will need about 5 to 6 skewers. And you will need a tablespoon of soy sauce, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of fish sauce, 1/2 teaspoon of pepper, and then you will also need 1 tablespoon of sesame seeds, 2 tablespoons of oil, and of course, honey. You're gonna need about 2 to 3 tablespoons of that. Need about 1 teaspoon of chili oil and 1 tablespoon of garlic chili sauce, which is this. It's a Korean Asian sauce. I love it. It's so delicious. And let's get this going. Okay, now have all your meat that's cubed, about that size, roughly all about that size, inside of a Ziploc bag, a big one, so that way you can marinate. And now what you will do is you will take all your ingredients and add them into, so your tablespoon of soy, teaspoon of miso, soy sauce, fish sauce. Fish sauce. Everybody gets a little confused. So, do. Now, not too much of this. This will make it stinky. And then you will need your 1/2 teaspoon of salt and pepper. Mix it all in there. And then you're going to add about roughly 1 tablespoon of sesame seeds. And then you're going to do 2 teaspoons of oil. Tablespoons of oil. I do apologize. It's 2 tablespoons. Then you're going to do about 1 tablespoon of chili garlic. And then what you're going to do is you're going to take 1 tablespoon, not that much, of the chili sauce. And then what you're going to do is you're going to take the honey. You're going to pour the honey. About 2 to 3 tablespoons should do it. And then what you do is you seal up the bag. And then you rub this all in. Just like that. You want to rub it out. And You can stick these on the skewers first, but it's better to marinate them before you stick them on the skewers so they're nice and tender. So now, that's all you need. Now, you stick that in the fridge and let it marinate for about an hour, and it'll be very delicious. And this is going to be our honeyaki. I custom made this blend. It's really good. Ta-da! What you're going to do, you're going to take all this delicious meat and you're going to put the skewers, it on the skewers. Some of them will be hard to push through. Now I cut up these from a roast. But they're rather fun to do. I quite like doing it. Now to start, I'm only going to show you how to do this. I will eventually show you how to do the stir fry rice. I posted on my Facebook page. This is great for if you got company coming over or just want something after work to do, because you can leave them marinate in the fridge, and if it's beef, it'll only take practically only minutes to cook. And as you can see, it's rather easy. So you want to put about 4 to 3 on there. And what I'm going to do is I only got enough, it looks like, here for 4 skewers. So you can even put 3 if you're having company. Now what you're going to do is make sure your gas is on. You don't want it too high. You want it high enough that it's going to be Now, as they cook, there you go, mine got pretty very funny. No problem, because I'm going to all disappear. Excellent. So you know, carefully that each was open. Now these you can do like steak, where you can have it rare, medium rare. There we go. Yeah, as they cook, you're going to want to pour all that delicious sauce that you marinated it in inside and let it just cook just like that. And I will throw that away and then go. Never reuse the same bag if you're using raw meat. If it's veggies, it's okay as long as they're not bad veggies. Never you reuse it if it's like raw meat, raw chicken, because it can cross-contaminate and make you rather sick. So as you can see, it's getting nicely cooked and it's starting to bubble in the sauce. Now I just turn up the heat slightly. Now the honey will make it start to thicken up a bit. And make sure you don't burn yourself if you don't use a fork or a tongs. I myself like to use my digits. So I always have one sticking up further ahead than down here. So this is where my shallow piece would be. And you just click them like you would a steak, and that's it. And all that sauce is gonna get nice and covered all over your meat. It's getting white there. So I'll just have to put that one. Now this is already almost done. Skewers, they're about done. Try to make sure you move the sauce or it will start burning. Tilt your skewers. Go like that. Now, these are almost done. You just gotta keep an eye in it and keep turning. It bubbles quick. You guys want to see more dishes like this? I will show you more. I can do a beef teriyaki, chicken teriyaki, you can even do this with chicken strips, but you gotta make sure the chicken strips is nicely white when you do that. All the way through. Beef, you can eat it rare, medium rare, well done, or just an atrocity if you want it well done. But it's up to you. Now, this. It's done. So I will take them. And I will place them on the plate. Oh, it smells so good. Now you let this just cook for another minute. Make sure you're careful. And now you're going to turn that off. I'm going to turn off my gas too, so this way I don't bring anything down. And then you see all that delicious sauce? What you're going to do with that is you're going to pour it over. Look at that. And then all that sauce. It's gonna make that look like that. Isn't that delicious? Oh, I can't wait to eat this. Oh, it's gonna be so delicious. Does have a little kick. You don't have to add chili oil. You can use just regular oil. You can change it up a little bit. But I quite like it this way when I add honey to it. It's so good. Anyway, I'm going to dig into this. See you in a few. Alright everybody, and that was Honeyaki Beef Skewers. I look forward to my next episode. Sorry for the not publishing last week. I had a hiccup with the video. I made salmon, but I tried filming it a different way, and turns out it didn't quite work the way I planned. Also, you couldn't see it due to my shoulder. I do have wide shoulders, so I tried to film it over my shoulder. Did not work. But today, I am dressed up in a nice little vintage pinup dress, and I am wearing a purple wig. This is one of my favorite wigs to go out with. It's so much fun. Go shake, 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 shake. Do, do, do. Anyway, I hope you guys have a lovely Easter, and enjoy your family time with family meals. Any suggestions, please post it. Next week, I am hoping to do Sailor Moon crepes, if you guys would like that, or maybe pancakes, if you guys would like to learn that. And then that week after is KupoCon, which is a Square Enix Final Fantasy con, which I am so excited to go to. I will be hoping to do an episode with a friend of my, one of my friends, dressed up for one of the Final Fantasy games. And we will do an episode of food from one of the games. It's so exciting. I made a new cosplay just for this one, and I can't wait to debut it on the video around the 21st. Anyway, you guys have fun. See you next time.